Hi there, Corey Barger here. This is Bassoon Lessons Online. Make sure you hit subscribe so you don't miss any lessons. Today I've got a quick little how-to for you about what to do when your bassoon does not want to fit together properly. This is really common in the winter months. Actually, it's really common year-round because the bassoon is really susceptible to changes in the wood and in the metal because of humidity levels changing. So if it's all of a sudden much colder than it had been before or much hotter, basically whenever there's any kind of drastic change, your bassoon might not want to fit properly. You will find either that the joints fall out or that you can't get them together. I'm going to give you a couple of tips for what to do when that happens. On my bassoon, I have a combination of string and cork tenons. You will probably most likely have either one or the other. A lot of times people will have totally string tenons with cork on the vocal. That's normal too. If you have cork, use cork grease. If you have string, do not use cork grease. No cork grease, okay? If your cork tenons don't fit together, cork grease usually solves the problem. Sometimes you may want to actually take it to a repair person so that the cork can be sanded down lightly. You can do this yourself if it's your instrument and you feel confident making small adjustments like this, but if it's not your instrument, do not do it. If you have a school instrument, you could ask maybe that the band director or the orchestra director do it for you, but really it's something that is best left to a teacher or to a repair person. If you have string tenons, you have a little bit more flexibility, so remember, no cork grease ever. These are designed to come off and be put back on. So look for the little tail end of your string. If you can't get one of the joints on, you need to have less string on there. So look for the end. I've done these myself, so I know where to put it, where to find it, and it's a lot easier to get off. So you can just unwind it. And you may need to do a bunch of revolutions to make it fit. And that's okay. Once you're finished unwinding it and the joint fits on, you snip the end of the thread and then you just tie a little knot in the end of it. Basically just tuck it under the other end. Don't make any large knots that will keep anything from going on smoothly. If it won't fit, you could rub a little bit of beeswax on there. That's what I do for mine. But again, that's not totally necessary, and a lot of the thread will have paraffin wax on it too, so you don't want to mix those two things. If you don't know what's on there, don't put anything else on. Once you've taken the thread off and cut it, make sure you keep that section of thread, because later, when the weather changes again, you're probably going to want to put it back on. So when you put it back on, all you do is just wind it back around, and however much you took off before, you need to check and see that the joints fit together again. And then just tuck the end under. Mine's pretty waxy, so it just kind of sticks down if I use the heat of my fingers. And there you go. So don't be afraid to remove or add thread on here. Whatever you do is not that consequential to how the instrument fits together. If you take all of it off, of course that's a problem, because you're going to need some of it. This helps to keep the seal in the instrument, so if there's no grab, then you might have problems with notes speaking and things like that. So don't take too much off. And if you do take it off, make sure you save it, because you will absolutely need it again. So that's what you do when you can't get your bassoon together. Hit subscribe and let me know in the comments if there are any other topics that you'd like me to cover. Thanks for watching Bassoon Lessons Online.